Hello and welcome. Today, we will be going over the first episode of the series where I show you how to rehabilitate a rescue bearded dragon. In each video, you will see a week's worth of progress with this rescue baby. I will go day by day to describe what is happening, why it's happening, and why it's important. So if this is something that interests you and may benefit you at all, then keep on watching. Again, and thanks for joining me on the rest of this episode. So, I wanted to start by telling you guys how I got this rescue dragon. One day when I was at work, and I work at a children's home for kids with disabilities, somebody came up to me and told me that there was somebody in the department that was trying to get rid of their bearded dragon. So I knew nothing about them. And they then stopped me in the hallway and said, "Hey, you're the lizard girl, right?" Because that's what I'm known at work for, the lizard girl. And he's like, "Oh, well, I have this bearded dragon, and I've had him for about 3 years, and we just need to find a new home for him and all of that." I was like, "Okay, cool, I can definitely take him off of your hands." I just knew that I was going to have to get a baby and find a home for a baby, because I honestly don't have the place for another dragon right now, because, well, I'm in my last year of college and trying to transition into a bigger place. It's too much to add a new addition to the home right now for good, so I knew that I had to find a new home for him. Well, about a week or so after that, we ended up meeting up. I met the individual at their house, and when I came in, I saw this bearded dragon sitting in a tub. Not a sink, but a tub. The things that I noticed was the bulb was not proper, and it was not nearly big enough for this dragon, and I assumed that they had been using this for the entirety of their life. I didn't see any UVB anywhere. Their substrate, there was only a few pieces of carpet on the bottom, and the rest was just bare tub. The baby was super skinny, so I was like, "Oh, we've got some work to do." I asked him about what he was fed and all of that. And apparently he was only fed bugs that were previously frozen, and the ones that he was showing me were not alive. So I think that he has been fed a lot of dead frozen bugs in his life. So I knew for a fact he was not going to be used to chasing live bugs. And so if all of this wasn't proper, then I assumed as well that he had never had supplements in his life either. When I went to go pick him up the first time, the poor baby just started running away from me, just running back and forth in the tub that he came with. And the individual told me that they had bought this dragon for their son, and the son had cared for him about a year, and then for the last 2 years has just completely not handled him much and honestly neglected him. So I knew I had to work on that. And then the only other things that he told me was that the dragon had gone by Fred, and for the entirety of his life, except for in that instance he had been on sand. And the last part is that he apparently had had mites at one point, but then they cured it. So I loaded the baby up along with the tub and all of the accessories that he came with, and then I brought him home and set him up. Check it out. So baby no name is right here right now. So as you can see, they're actually enjoying it and pancaking right now. The only reason why I have this bulb so close is because this is not the proper bulb for this baby, but it's the one that they gave me, so I'm using it right now because my other one died, of course. So I was lucky that they gave me this bulb as well. I wanted to bring that basking spot up because he had never had a basking spot before. So that's really the only way that that bulb would be sufficient enough, and even that isn't sufficient enough. But the heat was sufficient enough for the time, because he did have a big old poo. And what I learned from this poo was that he is dehydrated. He has massive fat pads on his head, but that is only from eating waxworms. That is the majority of the diet that he had, was waxworms and a little bit of crickets, but mostly waxworms. So that's where the fat came from, but there's not a lot of liquid in there. So that's why you have that yellow section of that urate. And if you have a yellow urate, then your baby needs more hydration. So just to list the things that I am going to be working on with this baby just right from the get-go is he's going to need to be switched to proper lighting. He's going to have to get used to UVB. And that's something as well, because if a baby has never had UVB, there is such thing as UVB sickness. He needs a better diet. He needs more water in his diet. He has never had proper supplements. And then finally, we need to work on handling, because I need to get him used to being handled again, because if he's used to being handled again, then it'll be easier for him to find a home because he'll be friendly. So with that being said, day one was filled with him just settling in. I kind of just let him be and let him settle in and get used to his surroundings. And I also found a few more things that we needed to work on as well. Take a look. Hello everybody and good morning. So right now I'm about to wake up baby No Name for their first ever morning, and as you can see, this is a makeshift setup I did last minute, but I do have a substrate, which right now I have a towel. I will put them on a mat once I get my other mat cleaned. I have some accessories in there. I have a basking spa. I'm working on getting this poor baby a bigger bulb, and at least an 150 watt bulb instead of a 75 watt bulb, which they're using right now. And I put them in a blanket for now, but we're gonna see how baby No Name takes getting up the first morning, guys. Pick you up, okay? One, two, three. I'm gonna pick you up. Here we go. Here we go. I'm picking you up, baby. All right. Day two with baby No Name slash Fred, and we are starting the lizard grooming process, which would be nail trimming, getting him weighed, and then some other fun stuff like, of course, feeding him. And we also worked on handling as well, which is a very, very full and extraneous day for any dragon on their second day in a home. But I needed to start this because I wanted to work up to getting him cleaned, because I don't want him to be sitting in his own filth for that long, but I didn't want to do too much in one day. So we didn't bathe him this day, but we started the grooming process this day. Take a look. Alright you guys, so I'm about to do the first couple of things that I need to do with baby No Name to get him started. And of course the first thing is feeding. So I have him on certain supplements right now. He's starting with the Repishi Superfoods Calcium Plus. I don't know if he's ever had supplements in his life. So we're gonna use this one. This one says it's an all-in-one supplement thing, but no matter how many times I've read over this, it doesn't say it has probiotics in it. So I put a little bit of probiotic in it, and then I put some bee pollen in it as well, because you can never go wrong with this, and it boosts the immune system. But as for that, I mixed all those up. I have an assortment of crickets, roaches, and super worms in there today for him to eat. And hopefully he'll like it, but we'll see. I gave him some worms that were already shed and molted to help the digestion. We're gonna see if he likes the roaches. Yeah, he does. So right now I am weighing them. Alrighty guys, so we need to clean him up a little bit. I need to clip his nails because they are razor sharp. Like, them things are tiny and they are razor sharp and long. So we're gonna do that. What a beauty. Yes. What a beauty. You're so special. You're so kind. You're so precious. And you're gonna find a great home. I'm gonna make sure that yes I am. Yes I am, precious. Yes I am. He's being held like such a big boy. Yes he is. Yes, yes, oh my goodness, oh my. So now it is day 3, and today is the day we give baby no name a bath, finally, because he was a little stink stinks. I was so hyped for this day, I could not wait, but I was trying to make it a slow process as well and not too much at one time. But in this video, we had such a great bonding experience. And so we went a few steps forward with the bonding and handling experience. But just remember, as with everything, there's a few steps forward and a few steps back. So this was a huge, huge step forward for our bond. Take a look. Alrighty, you guys. So right now what we're gonna do is we're gonna give baby No Name his very first bath. And what I did so far was I cleaned out his tub that he originally came with, and I chucked some of the wood pieces that he came with as well, because the wood was kind of chipping and falling apart in pieces, and you know, it's just not worth it at that point when it's falling apart, so I got rid of that. I did keep this log right here that he had, but I did clean it. Right now, we are gonna get him. I don't know if he is going to run away or not. We're gonna see, because he is warmed up now. Fingers crossed.
Sweetheart,
I'm gonna get you, okay? I'm gonna pick you up, hey? It's okay. It's okay. Shh, 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 shh. It's alright. Shh, 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 shh. Okay? Good job. You're halfway there. Good job. Good job. Oh my goodness. Good job. Alright, I'm gonna pick you up now, okay? Okay. Good job.
Someone likes baths. Does that feel good? Have you ever had a bath before? Look at that tub. Is that a happy Tottens? Are you a happy Tottens? Oh.
I'm trying to get you dried off, buddy. Trying to get you dried off, okay? Just chill out. You're gonna be cold if I don't. Okay? You okay? Good job. Good job, buddy. Good job, buddy. Did such a great job. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. Oh. He's so precious. He is. All they need is love. For doing such a good job. So it is day 4 and we had our very first greens attempt ever. Again, I will say attempt because it did not work all that well with him, which is not a surprise. Usually the first time with greens does not go well. But never ever be discouraged when trying to feed your baby greens, because there is always going to be a way that will work eventually. It's just you gotta find that way, and you also gotta find what greens they like and so forth. I also cooked some eggs for them to try. We also practiced more handling, and there was a little bit of feeding as well. Take a look.
Good morning, sweet baby. Good morning.
So far today, right now, we have an eager belly puss that really just wants attention right now, and Nyx is still sleeping in brumation. I might just call baby No Name Little Ta or something, because I feel kind of bad. Like, or Fred, I guess, but Fred just doesn't seem right for that little baby. I don't know. But it is time to feed the baby some greens, and we got our shipment of the calcium in, because I remember I had ran out of all the supplements, but I also got some medicine in as well. But right now it's time to feed them some greens, and I don't think baby No Name is gonna eat any greens, but we will see. It is also the day to feed them, so let's see. Alrighty, so making some eggs for the babe, and I'm honestly curious to see if he even eats these eggs, you know? And then of course, we use olive oil because beardies can consume this. It's all natural oil, extra virgin olive oil. Ellie is ready. Thank you.
He is not having it. Hello, sweet boy. I'm gonna pet you, okay? Hello. Hi. Hi, precious. Oh, I'm sorry. Alright, I'm gonna pick you up, okay? Here I come. Okay. Good boy. Good boy. See? That's not so hard. Oh my goodness. Wow. Good job. Good job, sweet boy. Hey, you're okay. You're doing such a good job. Yes, you are. You're doing an amazing job. Sweet boy. Alright, sweet boy. Hey. You're okay. You're okay. You're okay. Hey. Shh. You're okay. You are okay. Oh my gosh. This poor baby. Laughing so hard. Oh my god. You dumped the whole thing away. Oh my god. I have to get this little guy cleaned up. Oh my gosh.
And now it is day 5 and the final day for this video. And on this day, we open the shipment from beardeddragon.co. We give the baby some meds, and I go over how to do all of that. We have more feeding and more handling time as well, so take a look.
Look how sweet. Alright, sweet boy. Okay. I'm gonna pick you up, okay? I'm gonna shift you.
Good boy.
He's just a little stressed out, but he'll calm down a little bit. Hey, you're okay. You're okay, buddy. You're okay. Go, buddy. Wanna warm me?
Yum, yum. Alright you guys, so I got my package in from beardeddragon.co. Alright, so here is the dewormer. I got like a small tiny little thing, so it'll work for a little while. It says it lasts for up to 2 years, but this tiny little bottle is not going to last me for up to 2 years with all of the beardies that I have. And the nice thing about it is they give you a dosing chart as well and a syringe that comes with it. So it'll be easier for you to do it by weight, and I'm going to show you guys exactly how to do it so there's no confusion, because I really don't want you guys giving too much medicine to your beardie, because that's when there can become a problem. If you give your bearded dragon this medicine and they don't happen to have worms or like too much worms, then it's not going to hurt them, but if you give them too much of it, it can make them sick. So be careful with that. And you need a stick. And if you have the medicine like this, you need to be able to weigh them, so that means you need to have a scale. And then I got colloidal silver, which is a great thing to have in your bearded dragon kit, and it also has a syringe that comes with it, because it is something that cures things like respiratory problems, where you put it in a nebulizer, or it can also cure scale ailments, but it's just a really great thing to have. And then of course I got more calcium with D3. Okay, I guess I got two things of calcium with D3. So, of course we're gonna open one of these bad boys. We're gonna deworm today, and also feed some babies. All right, you guys, so now we're about to feed the babes, and we need to set up their supplements. And I'm going to do the same supplements for them today. So we're gonna put some of the calcium complex with D3 today. Put some of that in there. Put a little bit more. All right, and then probiotic powder, we have this. Get a little thing of it. Then bee pollen, because it's an amazing thing to have. You can toss it into greens or slurries. I also just kind of add it into their bug thing sometimes. Just add a little bit, you know. Okay. And this is why I love this calcium so much, because look how coated this guy is compared to the other calciums I use.
Fatality. Fight brutality. K.O. 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 K.O.
Can I get him? There we go. You are so precious. Oh my goodness. Get him, get him. Ah, get him. Oh no. Get him, get him. Stress, baby boy. You're doing so great, though. You really are. No more. Are you stressed out, baby?
Yes, we are. Okay. You did a great job. You did a great job. Yes, you did.
Alright, you guys. So he is a little stressed right now, as you can see. So I'm going to leave the room and let him be for about an hour or so. Come back, check on him, make sure he's okay. So I guess we will see you back then. Meanwhile, Belly's doing great. Hi, Bumpers. This is the chart I was given from beardeddragon.co in order to give the medicine for deworming. So right here, they even give you the method of measurement and how you can do it yourself on how they calculated all of these dosages per weight and whatnot. So first, what you're gonna need to do is you're gonna decide if your baby needs a low dose of it or a high dose of it. Remember, it doesn't hurt to deworm them even if they don't have that high concentration of worms. It just hurts if you give them too much of this medication. The last weight that I weighed him at was 259 grams, but I am going to have to weigh him again and see if we've made any progress since then or if we've declined at all. So let's see. Hi, sweet boy. I'm gonna pick you up, okay? Hey, 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 hey. It's okay. I'm just gonna pick you up, okay?
He is displaying a flat back and some stress marks. So he's stressed out with me still. He's moving too fast. I know, buddy, but we gotta get you healthy, honey. Right? I'm gonna touch you, okay?
You're okay. Hey, hey, hey. It's okay. Buddy, you're okay. Just put you back up there. Hey. In circumstances like this where they are freaking out and starting to run away from you, you have to pick them up. It's not going to help if you just let them run away from you, because then that's kind of a mechanism that works. You know, they see it as that works and I'll be able to get away and da 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 da. So you just got to pick them up and calm them down in your hands, and then they'll realize that that is a safe place in your hands. Eventually, it's just, you got to do repetition all the time, because remember, this baby is about almost 3 years old and has rarely had any contact or being held or anything like that.
Goodness. Oh, what a sweet boy. Oh, what a sweet boy.
So now we are at 266, so he has gained just a tiny, tiny little bit. It might be from some of the food that he's eaten today as well, so we gotta take that into account. But hey, from 259 to 266, that's awesome, buddy. Good job. Good job, buddy.
Alright, you guys, so I'm gonna see if he wants to eat some more crickets right now, because he only ate about 7 earlier, and then I also want to give him the meds as well. So I'm gonna feed him some and then see if he'll take the meds. Alright, he didn't want the crickets, so we're gonna see if he wants some roaches. Alright, so now he's at 266, so I have to respect that weight that I've been getting instead of the 259. So it says here that I'm still going to be on 0.25. So if you look at the syringe right here, here is 0.2, and then you go down to the halfway mark, 0.5. So we're going to fill it up to there, make sure we mix it up really well. Oh, I know. Oh, I know. I know. Hey, 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 hey. It's okay. Hey, hey, hey. Hey, buddy. Good job. I hope we can be friends afterwards. I really do. Please don't bite me. Wasn't so hard. Wow, look at that. That wasn't so hard at all. Oh my goodness. Good job. Good job, sweet baby. So that is all I have for you guys. And if you're still watching, be sure to like this video, share this video, subscribe if you haven't already. And if you would like to follow Baby No Name's progress and see him get to full and complete health, then stay tuned for next week's video. From my family to yours, have a wonderful, wonderful week. Mwah!